Watercolour white, ugh! Now, so many teachers and tutors and watercolours tell you not to use it, but I love it. For my realistic paintings, it's perfect for the job. And I'm going to show you some of the techniques I use with you today. And hopefully, you'll love it just as much as I do. Welcome to our YouTube channel. My name is Paul Hopkinson and I'm a wildlife artist and also an online tutor. Now, if you're new here, do take a look at my other videos available on my YouTube channel. And you've got nearly 300 videos to go through, so hopefully something for everybody. Now don't forget to click on subscribe to my YouTube channel and press that little bell icon as well, so that YouTube notify you when I publish new content for you to watch. Now today I'm going to show you some personal reasons why I just kind of love to use watercolour white paint. And really there's nothing to be scared about when using watercolour white. I had to use it as one of my main colours within my watercolour palette. There are certainly no rules to prevent people from using it. Now I'm a great believer in kind of using the materials that work for you personally and the kind of painting that you want to create. So as far as I'm concerned, nothing is really out of bounds. You're the artist and it's entirely your choice what you do with your paints. Now watercolour white, the thing is there's a variety of different manufactured ones on the market and they all vary in the way they tend to work and even how white is white. Now this is one I use, okay, but there's some other good ones on the market. But just make sure that whatever you use is opaque in nature, so it's got to be opaque, not semi-opaque, not semi-transparent, but opaque. Otherwise you'll find that depending on the consistency of the paint will depend on how well it covers the area you want it to cover. So let's say, for example, you want to put a white dot in the eye of, say, a cat or an owl or whatever it might be. Just kind of create that highlighted area. But to do that, you need that opaque white really to work. You want it to be really bright white. Okay, so how does it work? I'm going to show you with that particular one within my mixing palette here. Now, because my board is on that slight angle, which I normally have it on like that, I'm able to put some water down the bottom of this well and then drag the water up to the white I've just put in there, the same white paint, and get that consistency that I want. So I would work on, let's say, watery, milky, creamy, and fixed. So four different consistencies. And that way around, you've got some idea on how you want it to be. See, if you had your palette flat, that water would just completely flood the watercolour white, wouldn't it? And just completely dissolve it all and make it really, really watery. So having that board on a slight angle is really beneficial because then you can just drag that little bit of water and make it as thick or as thin as you want it to be. So let's say we'll start off with a watery consistency. So that's really watery there, isn't it? What we'll do, we'll load it, we'll roll it as we pull that brush away. Let's just pull that down there somewhere, okay? Probably about there for you. And then I'm going to get some clean tissue like that, or just about clean, and give it a tap, just the once will do. And that takes that residual paint off the tip of the brush. Just that, and then you can obviously work with a very fine tip. Now, watery paint, let's just paint a line of that in this dark area for you. This is one of my testing papers, by the way, when I'm working on a project, hence all the colours and notes. So I just thought I'd work on this for you. So let's just draw a little bit of a line there, all right? So there's just one simple line. Now, the thing is, when that dries with watercolour white, it will fade that little bit more. So when you first apply it, it looks really bright. You think, yeah, that's really good. But then it dries. So the only thing you got to think about with that is that when it is dry, you can then go over the top with another layer. We have to do it in one go. Otherwise, you start disturbing the white paint underneath. So that's probably more of a watery consistency. Now, if I work on a little bit thicker on that, so let's just go for more of a milky consistency, so a little bit more pigment, if you wish, within the white paint. A little more there, probably about there, okay? So this is now going to be milky, right? So let's say that one. Oh, look at the difference there already. So that's a milky consistency, so less water, more pigment. And that's how that one works. I know. Just so easy when you look at it, isn't it? Okay, so that's your milky one. We'll see what these look like when they're dry as well. And then I'm going to go for a creamy consistency. Make sure there's no water on your metal ferrule while you're doing this. Well, it just dilutes the paint as it runs down that metal ferrule into the paint. So this is more of a creamy one. Okay, load it, roll it, pull it away. You know the system now. Give it a tap. And then we'll try that one. Right, okay, here we go. Now that's creamy. Now, I know it's creamy because of the fact that if it was thick, you find the line will break as you pull down the paper. So you know it's not going to break, but it's close to that kind of level, you know, so it's nearly to the thick consistency. So if we go for thick now, just wash that brush out a minute, otherwise I'm going to end up getting black paint into my white paint, which is not a good idea. So thick has got very small amounts of water added to it. Something like that, straight into it. Okay, load it, roll it, pull away, give it a tap. And now this is thick white paint. And now you can see again, look how it's broken on the paper there. Look, it's just broken away on the texture of this kind of cold pressed watercolour surface I've got here. So that's thick paint, how that works. So watery, milky, creamy, and thick. And that gives us some general idea on how bright those colours are. So I'll tell you what we'll do. I'll just get that dry with a hairdryer and I'll come back to you. And then we'll add another layer over the top. And in fact, I'll tell you what I'll also do. I'll have a bigger block of this further down as well. Okay, that's nice and dry. So I'm going to come back in now and add another watery layer over and see what that looks like, actually, out of interest. So watery over watery. See, that's even watery than that one, more waterer. Is that watery or waterer? You know what I mean. So let's add a second layer over the top and see what happens. Okay. We'll do the same with milky. It's a little bit thicker, not much more, just a little bit more. Probably something like that. Give it a tap. And then we'll add another layer over that one. Okay, just about. And then we'll go back in again. Now we're going to make it to a creamy consistency. So the second layer of white. The only thing you've got to think about when you're doing this is do it in one fell swoop. Otherwise, again, you're going to start to move the colour underneath, which you will do. So just on one line there, one line below it. And then we're going to go for the thick. Really, really thick stuff. There we are. Thick, thick, really thick. And then we're going to add that over this one. As you can see, it's just breaking away, as it always does when it's far too thick. So that'll do for that. And what we'll do, actually, once that's all on there and dry, we'll kind of compare them when they're nice and dry. And then I might add a little bit of colour over the top. So now you can see the variation within having watery, as in the top one, milky, next one down, creamy, you can see that's even brighter, and then thick. That's extremely bright, isn't it? So I'll give you some ideas how watercolour white tends to work and how much it can fade on your watercolour surface. So just remember, more water you add, the duller the white will be. All you need to remember really when you're working with white paint, when you're working with a bird painting, or you know, anything to do with painting birds really, anything like that, then just make sure that you know you're working using that in the same way you would normally use your normal paints. So don't try and use it any differently to any other colours that you have. So when you're working with, say, four different consistencies, from watery to milky to creamy to thick, then you find that using this watercolour white won't be used any differently to the other colours that you have within your painting kit. Okay, so if you're working with feathers, fine lines, anything, all the directions that you've got to use, it should work exactly the same. So don't treat it any differently to any other colour. If you do need to check the opacity of the watercolour white, very often it will show you that on the tube of paint as well. And if it doesn't show you that, have a look at the manufacturer's website and you very often also find you can download a colour diagram of all the paints that you use. Well, the entire range of paints that they have. The white paints that I tend to recommend are going to be the Winsor & Newton Titanium White. That's the professional brand. So Winsor & Newton Professional Titanium White, and also the SAA, Society for All Artists, their version of white as well, which is opaque. And both are opaque in nature, which is really, really good. You can, of course, use white gouache instead if you wanted to. So, I mean, white gouache is a good medium to use. I mean, it's very similar to watercolour. It's still water-based, but it's a thicker pigmentation within that paint. So because of that, it does cover quite well. Now, the other thing worth bearing in mind as well is that the more lines you add closer together, the thicker and the brighter the white will become. And the other good point about it as well is that once that watercolour white is dry, don't forget you can add another layer over the top. But remember to do this in one light pass, okay? So one fell swoop. Now the thing that I like about watercolour white as well is that you can overlay it. You can go over the top of previously applied details, which is really useful. I mean, sometimes in this case of the robin, there's already several layers of paint that have already been applied to this painting. Okay, so that means I can add this over the top with no problem whatsoever. We'll just go back to the demonstration and I'll show you how that works. Okay, so that's nice and dry, so I'm going to get a little bit. Let's go for burnt sienna. That's a nice colour, isn't it? A little bit of burnt sienna in there. And what we'll do, make sure it's not too thick. Oh, I'll tell you what I'll do as well. Let's get some lemon yellow. Why not? Let's get a little bit of that lovely lemon yellow colour. And again, I want that more to a watery consistency, so not too thick. And we use that to kind of overlay. Let's just do half of it, shall we? There's one. All right. Little bit of the burnt sienna for the other side. Two. So you see, I'm just doing one area in one go. If I keep going over that same area again, it's going to blur as I go over it. So burnt sienna. There you go. And the lemon yellow. Make sure you wash your brush out in between. And so on. But you can see how this is starting to get brighter and more vivid in colour. Look at that, look. See, that's the creamy version adding this colour in. So the creamy version starts to get that little bit brighter and more intense on the colours. And then we'll go in for the really thick stuff. Let's get a little bit more in there. It's a really thick. There you go. See, I've gone over it twice. It's starting to move the white paint. So this is what you've got to be careful of when you're working with white paint. The more you go over the area, the more the white starts to lift off. Okay. Unless you use white acrylic, which you can do, but it's more of a permanent fixture. You've got to be careful when you put a colour over the top of watercolour white. So that'll give you some ideas on the different consistencies and how I tend to work with watercolour white. So from really, really watery to the milky, creamy, and then finally thick. And also adding a little bit of colour over the top. Now whilst I'm working on this robin, I decided to use a little bit, just a little bit of raw umber and yellow ochre because I wanted to add a bit of colour to the chest because I don't want it to be kind of stark white. So I've used a colour overlaying technique in order to achieve this. However, you still got to be very careful with it because you don't want to move that white paint, do you? So just be very careful when you do go over watercolour white, do this in one fell swoop, so just one go, one very light pass of the paint you point over there. Now check out the card to the top right for more detailed tutorials on painting feathers. Now if you're finding my watercolour white video really useful for you today, do me one little favour and click on that thumbs up icon down at the bottom of this video. If you however want to put more paint over that, you can do that, but do that once it's nice and bone dry. So give it a blast from a distance though with a hairdryer so it's nice and dry, and then you can go over the top again with another thin one light pass again of colour. So think about not just the brush directions, think about the angles of the brush as well. So look at the feathers, look at the way the lines go. Are they curved? Are they straight? What direction do they go in? I like to refer to a clock face, believe it or not. So when I'm looking at a clock face, I'm looking at 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock. We all know our clock, I know. But look at the direction that the feathers go in. Are they going more towards a 3 o'clock direction? More towards 4 o'clock? And so on. So that's very, very important. You've got to look at those directions. And also, I tend to look at the thickness of the brush strokes. So how fine are they? How thick are they? And that also depends on the kind of loading technique you've got within your brush. So how to load that brush and working on the thickness of the lines is very, very important. Now, do you see that little card to the top right-hand corner of the screen? Well, that's a collection of videos that all focus on using watercolour white paint. Consider the amount of pressure that you apply when you're working with watercolour white as well. So, obviously, the more pressure you put on, the thicker the line will become. And that also depends as well on how much paint you've got loaded on your brush. So the more paint you have on there, the thicker the line will undoubtedly be. The thicker and blobbier the line will be in due course. So make sure that you take that little bit of paint off that brush before you go to the painting. Now, I hope I've managed to convert you to somebody that kind of uses and embraces white paint. So just let me know how you get on. How do you use white paint anyway? Let me know in the comments down below. I'll see you in the set of videos tomorrow, right, which is all about painting robins. Let's get the brushes wet.